Hi, this is Clay King from AAA Flood Drying, and today I wanted to show a method for removing water from a wet pad. A lot of times if you're trying to save the carpet, you need to get the water out of the pad. One method of getting the water out of the pad is to directly suck the water out of the pad with a wand, a carpet wand. And you can't usually use one from a wet vac, it's usually going to be a carpet type wand. A Bissell wand will work as well. We generally use these portable extractors for when we're doing flood work. They have advantages and disadvantages. One advantage is it's extremely convenient and it's very portable. It works well, we can take it anywhere. And so we use these a lot. And this is going to be more similar to what you may have advantage of or use of when you're using a wet vac. So if you take a wet vac and use a Bissell wand, it'll be very similar to what I'm going to use. The end of the wand down here is what is critical for cleaning the water out of the pad or the carpet. In this house, the carpet's gotten wet and the pad has gotten wet and they're soaked. Now, we are taking both of them out on this house, but I'm just using this as an example to show you what we can do. So, one other thing is, this works well with this setup, but if you use a carpet truck, they have so much vacuum in the head that when they put a carpet truck to try to suck up the water out of a pad, it literally sucks the pad up off of the floor and it bunches and it causes tears like that. And that's something that we don't usually run into because this has just the right amount of suction, so it works well and we usually don't do that kind of damage. So I'm going to turn on the vacuum. And if you were drying out your own carpet pad, you would be saving the carpet, you would fold the carpet back, you would suck the water out of the carpet first, so you're going to suck the water out of the carpet, and then you're going to fold the carpet back. The pad is still going to be very wet. So then you're going to want to take your wand, and you're going to want to suck the water out of the pad, and you're going to want to make multiple passes, and you don't want to go too fast. If you go too fast, it's not going to get a lot of water out. You make slow passes and you suck the water out. When you get done, once you've done a larger area, you want to wait a little bit and you want to do it a second time. And you want to go slow again. And that will remove a lot of the moisture out of the pad. Once you've done it twice, you can fold your carpet back down and then re-extract your carpet again. Probably two more times. You want to get as much moisture out as you can. You want to suck the moisture out of the pad and out of the carpet, and then you want to put an air mover going underneath the carpet to float the carpet on a cushion of air to dry out your carpet. Hopefully this has been helpful to you in your flooded basement situation. Thank you for watching. Clay King, AAA Flood Drying, and we're located in Westford, Mass., and we serve all of Massachusetts and New Hampshire. Thank you.